All right, I'm ready.
Good evening. I'm Dr. Emmett Brown. I'm standing on the parking lot at Twin Pines Mall. It's Saturday morning, October 26th, 1985, 1:18 a.m., and this is temporal experiment number one. Come on, Einie. Hey, boy, get in there. That a boy. In you go. Get down. Get your seatbelt on. That's it.
Whoa. Okay.
Please note that Einstein's clock is in precise synchronization with my control watch. Got it?
Right. Check, Doc.
Good. Have a good trip, Einstein. Watch your head.
You got that thing hooked up to the car?
Watch this.
Yeah, okay. Got it.
Not me. The car. The car. If my calculations are correct, when this baby hits 88 miles per hour, you're gonna see some serious shit. Watch this. What did I tell you? 88 miles per hour! The temporal displacement occurred at exactly 1:20 a.m. and 0 seconds!
Ow! Doc, what would happen to the car?
Calm down, Marty. I didn't disintegrate anything. The molecular structure of both Einstein and the car are completely intact.
Where the hell are they?
The appropriate question is, when the hell are they? You see, Einstein has just become the world's first time traveler. I sent him into the future. 1 minute into the future, to be exact. And at precisely 1:21 a.m. and 0 seconds, we shall catch up with him and the time machine.
Wait a minute. You put your dog in a time machine made out of a DeLorean?
The way I see it, if you're going to build a time machine into a car, why not do it with some style? Besides, the stainless steel construction made the flux dispersal. Look out!
Doc?
That's peculiar.
Where's the car, Doc?
It should have caught up with us 27 seconds ago.
Doc, what happened to Einstein?
No need for concern. It's probably just a minor miscalibration of the time circuit. Marty, could you get my notebook? It should be in the toolbox. No time to talk now, Marty. Go to the toolbox and get that notebook.
What's in the box?
Don't touch that! It's plutonium!
Plutonium?
How do you think I generated 1.21 gigawatts of power?
Notebook. Got it. Flux capacitor?
That's it!
What the heck's a flux capacitor?
My latest invention. The thing that makes time travel possible. In this notebook, I've detailed the nearly 3 decades of scientific breakthroughs necessary to build a working time machine. If it ever fell into the wrong hands, the consequences could be catastrophic. Let's see. It's mass equals I times Z, and E equals the square root of Z times C squared, and the flux dispersal rate is inversely proportional to the fourth root of N, carry the 9, then. Let's see. It's mass equals I times Z, and E equals the square root of Z times C squared, and the flux dispersal rate is inversely proportional to the fourth root of N, carry the 9, then.
Doc, shouldn't we get out of here before the Libyans show up? Doc?
Great Scott!
Doc, what is it?
I've made a horrible mistake!
Doc! Doc, no!
I'm sorry, Marty.
Doc, come back! Doc! Doc!
Marty, is everything okay?
Yeah, Mom, it was just a nightmare. I was in the past, and Doc was there.
Well, you're safe and sound now, back in good old 1986. But you'd better get up. Your father's waiting for you.
Huh?
Weren't you going to meet him over at Doc's?
Holy crap, I'm late! Dad, are we too late to stop the sale?
Better late than never.
You wouldn't believe how much rare stuff there is back here.
That's Doc's stuff. The city has no right to.
Now, son, I know you're upset, but your friend's been gone for months, and the city really seems hell-bent on using his land for that new parking garage. And hey, is that a first edition Jules Verne?
It's just not fair. But at least things can't get any worse.
Hey, Marty.
Hi, Biff.
Come to see if the old crackpot had any buried treasure?
Nah, I guess I'm just remembering. Doc built this model of downtown Hill Valley way back in 1955. The clock tower in the courthouse even works. What the? Is that Doc's notebook in there?
Hey, that looks just like the courthouse. You gotta hand it to the old coot. He was good with his hands.
Biff, can I see that a minute?
This would look great in my fish tank. Give the old carp something new to nibble on.
Can I see that model courthouse for just a second? I need to get something out of it.
Like what? A not guilty verdict? That was a joke.
Oh, ha. But really, can I?
Nah, I think I'll hold on to it.
Give it here, Biff.
Well, well, looky what we have here. Looks like plans for something. What's a flux catheter?
It's none of your business. Doc asked me to...
Brown's worm food, kid. But this looks like it might be worth something.
Hey, Biff. I just can't let you keep that notebook. It's dangerous.
What, is it set to explode or something?
Well, in a way.
I'll take my chances.
only want that notebook because, well, I'm sentimental. It's like a piece of Doc.
Doc's dead. Time to get over it and move on.
That notebook wouldn't mean anything to you. You wouldn't even understand what's in it.
You calling me ignorant?
I'll pay you for it.
How much?
Not
enough.
I just can't let you keep that notebook. It's dangerous.
What, is it set to explode or something?
Well, in a way.
I'll take my chances.
Never mind. It took me forever to repair this thing after I blew it out last time, and now some jerk's gonna pick it up for pennies. Let's make some noise. Hey, Dad, why's my guitar got a price tag on it?
Sorry, son. Must have been an overzealous clerk. Just pick it up. I'll iron things out with the bank.
I better not crank it up anymore. I really don't want to blow this thing out again. Here's an oldie, but a goodie. 1, 2, 3.
Hey, look! It's Chuck Butthead. Let me show you how it's done.
Now, Biff, I think that's Marty's guitar.
You're right, Mr. McFly. Oh, here you go, Marty. Let's hear a few licks.
Man, you kids have ruined rock and roll.
Hey, Dad. Who's running this sale anyway?
Oh, that'd be me, son.
You? Why?
Well, once it became apparent that the bank was going through with the sale, I volunteered to oversee it in order to make sure that Doc's stuff would be treated with a modicum of respect. Isn't that right, Biff?
You got it, Mr. McFly.
I'll keep looking around. Thanks, Dad. And now, something your kids are really gonna like.
Thanks for warming them up for me, Butthead.
Biff, I thought I told you not to take my son's guitar.
Oh, right. Sure thing, Mr. McFly. I was just warming them up for you, Marty. Let's see what you got. Man, you kids have ruined rock and roll.
I better not crank it up anymore. I really don't want to blow this thing out again. Hey, Biff. Never mind. Now that is a dangerous amp.
You want to hear a number by Biff and the Biff Tones? Always happy to play for my adoring fans.
Now, Biff.
Oh, yeah. Here you go, Marty. Man, you kids have ruined rock and roll.
Hey, Dad. About Biff. Dad, I know you're trying to help.
He talks a big game, son, but he's not so tough. I've been dealing with him a long time. Believe me, I can handle him.
So can I.
I guess you can. Okay, son, I'll stay out of your way, but you know where to find me.
Do you think dreams can predict the future?
Well, you know I don't go in for that mystical stuff, but I do think they can reflect how you're feeling about the future.
I'm telling you, this sale is a joke. Doc's only been gone for a few months, and I happen to know...
Yes, you've told us he's not dead. He's on a trip. Let's say you're right. Have you considered that this trip may not have been entirely voluntary? I hate to say it, but Doc's run up some pretty sizable debts around town. Maybe he's just hiding from his creditors.
You got Doc wrong. Sure, maybe he's not so good with money. That's just because his mind's always on bigger things. But he's still a straight-up guy. He'd never run away from his problems.
Well, you know him better than I do, son. But the bank is within its rights to sell off his stuff. Maybe you should try to find some things to remember him by before Biff grabs them all. Problem? Biff?
He's got this thing, see, and I really need to get it back.
If he stole something from you...
No, it's one of Doc's notebooks. He found it first, but...
Oh... Well, then I'm not sure what to tell you. I guess you'll just have to appeal to his better angels or something.
Or something. I'll keep looking around. Thanks, Dad. I better not crank it up anymore. I really don't want to blow this thing out again.
You want to hear a number by Biff and the Biff Tones? Always happy to play for my adoring fans. Now watch me blow the lid off this joint.
Whatever you say.
Whoa!
Rock on, Biff.
Oh, shit.
Doc, where are you? Doc? Einstein! Where do you come from, boy? Didn't you bring Doc with you? Looks like the time circuits still work. Now I only need to know when to look for Doc.
Marty?
Ah!
Marty! if you're hearing this recording, then the DeLorean's automatic retrieval feature is a resounding success.
Automatic retrieval?
In case of my failure to return to the DeLorean within an allotted time, I programmed the time machine to jump to these four-dimensional coordinates without me. As you are well aware, time travel is an inherently risky activity, and despite my elaborate precautions, there's always a possibility that I could land in trouble sometime. And that sometime is now, or then, or maybe later.
He's in trouble.
Marty, you've come to my rescue in the past, or was it the future? Anyway, I'm relying on you to do it again. Please, take the DeLorean back, or forward, to whatever it is. I'm stuck in time. When you get there, I'm sure you'll figure out what to do.
That's it? Aren't you going to tell me when that is?
Just go to the date specified on the time circuit readout under the heading marked Last Time Departed. Good luck.
Right. Last Time Departed. Oh, jeez. Come on. Crap! Oh, great. How am I supposed to find him now? Okay, Doc, I know I haven't seen you in a few months, but I'm pretty sure this isn't your shoe. I can use those to enter a date into the time circuits, once I know when to look for Doc. I probably shouldn't fiddle with the time circuits again until I know when to look for Doc. What kind of trouble is Doc in, Einie? What do you know about this shoe, Einie? Great Scott! I think he's onto something! Okay, now we're getting somewhere. How's this supposed to lead me to Doc, Einie?
Step away from the door!
Ah!
Now, let me get a look at you.
Einstein, come on!
Just as I suspected. Hooligans! Get along now! Scat!
Can you let me in? I've got something to show you.
What is it? Let me see. A shoe? Wow, now what would I want with a... Huh? Stay there!
Sorry, Einstein.
Well, took you long enough.
There's a lot of stairs.
To return the shoe, I mean. I lost it ages ago. You can put it down next to the other one. Much better. So neat and orderly. I suppose you'll be wanting some sort of reward now.
No, I...
All I've got is tea and candy.
but...
I'm sorry I called you a hooligan. I try not to jump to conclusions, but after all, 9 out of 10 people in this city are hooligans. It's a fact. Look it up. Have a seat, Sonny.
Hey! You kids! Put out those cigarettes!
Don't touch those! My newspapers are in pristine condition and meticulously organized. Not about to let some street punk get jam all over them. Oh, I wouldn't do that if I were you. Ms. Pretty Whiskers is very particular about who handles her food.
Is that Vice Principal Strickland?
Mother never could keep little Gerald out of her clothes.
I can't leave now. Miss Strickland's my only hope of finding Doc. Miss Strickland, about your tea. You forgot to turn on the...
You! It's spelled with a U, you illiterate vandal!
Marshall Strickland.
My grandfather, gunned down by Mad Dog Tannen over 100 years ago.
That's not how I remember it. Miss Strickland?
Jack! Diane! I know what you're doing behind that tree!
Yes?
Do you remember when you lost your shoe?
Shoe?
That shoe over there.
Oh, that shoe! Hi, what a nosy Nelly! No one likes a busybody, you know.
But...
Oh, fine, let me think about it. Yes, I remember. I lost it in a scuffle with a dog.
Oh, when was it?
Oh, yes! The day that speakeasy burned down.
A speakeasy? In Hill Valley?
Don't act so surprised, young man. Your generation doesn't hold a copyright on moral depravity, you know. Sin has been on the prowl in Hill Valley since the day it was founded.
Doing some stargazing?
No, I set my sights on lower things. Is that...
Biff Tannen! Get away from that hubcap before I call your father!
What's with all these newspapers?
This is my personal archive. I've got every issue of the Hill Valley Telegraph ever published.
Get out. Every single issue?
From 1871 to the present. If it happened in Hill Valley, you'll find it in my stacks.
Wow, a speakeasy. That must have been wild. Is it true they used to drink gin out of slippers like my grandma said?
Don't romanticize the past, young man. Prohibition was a time when gangsters ruled the town while honest citizens quaked in their beds.
So where was it? That speakeasy that burned down, I mean.
That was ages ago. If you're looking for bootleg hooch...
No, I'm just curious, that's all. I'm a student of history.
Student of history? My Aunt Fanny! Yeah, your generation of hooligans and slackers could give two ripe figs about history.
Miss Strickland?
Oh, video store!
Huh?
The speakeasy used to be hidden in plain sight down there in the town square. Right where that disgusting videotape rental store squats today.
So the video store building must have gone up after the speakeasy burned down.
The following year, as I recall.
Don't let me keep you from your business.
You there! Don't even think about tossing that Kleenex on the ground!
Mind if I take a look?
Go ahead, dear.
Rebuilt in February 1932. So the fire must have happened before then. But when? I need a date.
Don't look at me. I'm far too old for you.
Man, she keeps it hot in here.
That's the kettle. I'll be right back with some tea. Then don't touch anything!
Let's see. Ground broken on site of former speakeasy, singer vanishes, Hill Valley Expo delights crowd, soup kitchen exposed. Here we go. Speakeasy arsonist slain. Legal procedure gave way to old-fashioned vengeance last night when a mob descended on the Hill Valley police station. The suspect in the speakeasy arson case, a drifter known as Carl Sagan, was pulled from his... Carl Sagan? It's Doc! Killed by a mob. What's the date? June 14th, 1931. Jeez, I gotta rescue him.
My newspapers!
Sorry, Miss Strickland. Let me...
No! You've gotten my history out of order! Oh, do you know how long it'll take to fix what you've done? Oh, get out! Get out! Get out!
Help! Police! I'm being attacked by hooligans!
Marty! Where you been, son? And what are you doing in that getup?
Didn't I tell you? I got the lead in the school play. We're doing...
Grapes of Wrath?
Right!
Oh, Steinbeck! Who are you playing? Never mind, you don't have to explain. I'm sure whatever it is you're up to, you know what you're doing, right?
I hope so.
Hey, sometimes you gotta go out on a limb for the ones you love, right? Wish my dad had understood that. You won't stay away too long.
You'll barely know I was gone. You ready to go, Einstein? Time circuits, on. Flux capacitor, fluxy. Okay, if Doc's gonna get killed on June 14th, 1931, I'll just show up the day before and get him out. I hope you know what you're doing, Doc. Einstein, where'd you go now, boy?
Excuse me, young man!
Who? Me?
You're the only man in the street, and I'm looking for a man-in-the-street reaction. Naturally, you know about the explosion that destroyed this illegal gin establishment.
I read about it, yeah.
What's your opinion of Carl Sagan, the stranger who single-handedly did what the law has been unable to do for 10 long years, namely, rid Hill Valley of the scourge of liquor?
You can mark me down as a supporter.
The young man said, flashing a boyish yet virile grin. Hill Valley needs more upstanding youths like yourself. Do you have a message for the vicious gangsters who still roam these streets, no doubt plotting to corrupt our citizens with another den of booze, sin, and debauchery?
No, not really.
That's the spirit! Destroy them with indifference! If we refuse to patronize their establishments and glorify their wicked exploits, they'll soon be exposed for the pathetic wretches they are! May I get your name?
Yeah, it's Sonny Crockett.
Thank you for sharing your candid opinions, Mr. Crockett. Edna Strickland, Hill Valley Herald.
I know. I met you back. I mean, I'm familiar with your work.
You read my column? How sweet! I know it's just an etiquette column, but I believe it'll lead to bigger and better... Oh!
Einstein, no! Down, boy!
Is this wretched creature yours? He assaulted me once before.
What's got into you?
Aggressive dogs must be kept on leash at all times. It's the law. Look it up.
Doc, I gotta find Doc. I guess this is where the speakeasy burned down. How'd Doc ever get mixed up in that? Bank of Italy? Valley Police Station. Cripes, this place looks old, even for 1931. Psst, Doc!
Marty!
Doc!
What are you doing here?
You sent for me, Doc.
I did? When?
May 14th,
1986. 1980? The automatic retrieval system, of course. I'd almost forgotten about that.
So what's our plan for getting you out of here?
Plan? We don't need a plan.
We don't.
Not in the slightest. The police picked me up for that speakeasy fire a couple of weeks ago, but the DA hasn't got a case. They're releasing me tomorrow morning.
So basically, I traveled 50 years into the past to deliver your car?
Sorry about that, but it's so wonderful to see you. We have a lot of catching up to do.
Yeah, you might want to hold off on that, Doc.
Great Scott! I'm going to be gunned down by gangsters on the steps of the courthouse!
Why would they do that?
Guess they didn't approve of my burning down their speakeasy.
Very funny, Doc. Maybe now we should come up with a plan?
A plan? Right. But what?
Why don't I take the DeLorean, go back in time before you were arrested, and stop you from getting caught in the first place?
Don't even think about it. Without my unjust incarceration, the events that sent you into the past might never happen, resulting in a paradox of continuum-shattering proportions.
Jeez, we've been back together for 5 minutes, Doc, and you're already talking about the end of the universe. I've missed that.
Don't be ridiculous, Marty. I was only referring to the end of the universe as we know it.
Well, I suppose I could just get some dynamite and break you out of jail.
No, that's far too dangerous. Not just to me, but to random innocent people in the past. The repercussions could be... That's it!
What's it?
My rocket-powered drill.
You have a rocket-powered drill?
Not yet. I haven't built it yet.
You've lost me, Doc.
Listen. A few months ago, my 17-year-old self sent in a patent application for a rocket-powered drill. I abandoned the project after I never heard back from the patent office, but the prototype should be nearly complete.
Great, I'll just run back to your lab and...
No, I said nearly complete. You need me to help you finish it.
How the hell am I supposed to sneak a half-finished rocket-powered drill into your cell?
Not me! 1931 me!
Wait a minute, Doc. You want me to convince your 1931 self to build a rocket-powered drill to break you out of jail?
Precisely!
Okay, let's say I go along with this crazy idea. Where can I find you? The other you.
How should I know? It was over 50 years ago. Why don't you go over to the soup kitchen next door and give my house a call? They'll know where to find me.
Soup kitchen. Got it.
Just stay away from the soup. It'll cause irreparable damage to your digestive system.
I guess I better get started. Don't worry, Doc. I'll get you out of here in no time.
I'm not worried. Once you and my younger self put your heads together, you'll be unstoppable.
Doc!
Marty! Have you found my younger self yet?
How do you remember this phone number after 50 years?
It's a mnemonic for a dirty punchline I learned when I was 12. Now, get to the soup kitchen and find out where I am.
Where have you been all this time? I missed you.
I've missed you too, Marty. But I thought it was important to let you live your own life for a while, free from the insanity of time travel.
I gotta admit, it was nice to not have my family history blowing up in my face for a few months.
Besides, I've been busy raising my own unpredictable teenagers.
How'd you wind up in jail in 1931 anyway?
During my trip to the past, I decided to look into one of Hill Valley's unsolved mysteries.
The fire at the speakeasy.
Exactly. I thought I was safely hidden across the street. But when the fire started, there was a tremendous explosion, and I was knocked unconscious by a stray brick. When I woke up, I was here in jail, charged with arson.
That's horrible.
I know. Worse yet, I still don't know who started the fire.
What do you know about Edna Strickland?
Edna? We never really socialized when I was younger. She was a few years older than me, and we traveled in different socioeconomic circles. Why do you ask?
She thinks you're a hero for burning down that speakeasy. She's doing a story on you.
A story? Oh, yes. Now I remember. Ask Edna, the etiquette column that doubled as a pro-temperance soapbox. She believed that the consumption of alcohol would inevitably lead to a complete societal breakdown.
Sounds like a fun gal.
You should have seen her when the hippies started showing up in the 60s. She just about lost her mind.
That would explain a lot. Hang in there, Doc.
Not the best choice of words, Marty.
McFly! Biff? Kid! Grandpa?
That's Mr. Tannen to you, Artie. What are you doing out here?
Well, I was getting kind of hungry,
So I figured I'd come down here for some free soup.
Just thought I'd come down for some soup. Think, McFly. The DA's throwing around subpoenas like Babe Ruth.
I don't think Ruth's a pitcher anymore.
Shut it. If one of those subpoenas landed in the hands of my number cruncher, I'd be in a whole lot of trouble. I could even get sent up the river. You wouldn't want that, would you? Would you?
No, of course not, kid.
All right, that's better. What are you looking at, punk?
Keep your eyes on the soup, kid.
Well?
Well, what?
Well, what are you still doing here?
Sorry, kid. I'll just run back to the safe house.
You do that. And McFly?
Yes?
That hat's too flashy. You better let me hold on to it. Now scram!
You got it, boss.
And don't come out until I give you the all clear. I swear, if even one of you mooks could add 2 + 2 without your fingers, I'd dump that wimp into the lake. Hey! Anyway, I'm off to make myself irresistible. Don't let anyone burn down the shop while I'm gone.
Brown residence?
Hi. Do you know where I could find Emmett Brown?
Young Master Brown is currently tending to his clerking duties at the courthouse. Who may I say is calling?
The courthouse? Doc never told me he worked at the courthouse.
Touch those. These are very sensitive legal documents. Nobody is supposed to handle them but sworn officers of the court. Judge Brown says so.
Judge Brown? Doc. Nice to meet you. I'm, Sonny Crockett.
Emmett Brown. But I am a law clerk, not a doctor. Now please get out of my way. I have important business to transact.
H2A multiplied by the inversion of H has to come out less than expectation value of A, right? What am I missing here? Or do we take H as the inverse H2A multiplied by the inverse of A might not be equal to A's expectation value, but only if the coefficient of friction remains constant and the gravitational constant is variable. Wait, is that even possible? Oh, let's start over. Force equals mass times acceleration, of course.
Listen, Emmett, you don't know me, but I'm your friend.
I'm not big on friends. They get in the way of work.
Listen, I understand you're working on a new invention in your lab.
Invention? You must have me mixed up with somebody else. I'm in law. I have absolutely no interest in science.
Come on, wait up a minute.
You again? Can't you see I'm busy?
Okay, so you don't want your old man to know. That's fine. Listen, we all keep secrets. But I'm telling you, you can level with me about this science project of yours.
I am not a scientist. Go ahead, ask me what E equals.
What does E equal?
I have absolutely no idea. See? I don't know where you got your information from about me, mister, but you're wrong, wrong, wrong!
Will you just give me a chance?
Harassment's a federal crime, Mr. Crockett!
Come on, you could trust me, Doc. Emmett. It's your future I'm looking out for, in more ways than one.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about you and science.
Oh, that word again! If you insinuate I'm a scientist once more, I'll sue you for defamation of character!
Gale, Zemeckis, and Fine. Attorneys at law. No solicitors. Gale, Zemeckis, and Fine. Attorneys at law. No solicitors.
Not possible. No. Or do we take a...
Will you just give me a chance?
Harassment's a federal crime, Mr. Crockett!
Come on, Doc. Emmett, drop the legal act. I got something more important for you to do.
Mr. Crockett, I'll have you know that the law is the very mortar that holds society together. And we in the legal profession are like brick masons building the edifice of the future.
Your dad tell you that?
Every morning.
So, Emmett, what time are you through with work?
Depends. On weeknights, Pop sometimes keeps me in the office till 9.
9 at night? But today's Saturday.
Right. So I probably won't get off before 10.
How about you knock off work early and I'll buy you a beer, or soda. What do you say?
Don't try to tempt me from my duty with sugary beverages. Keeping the wheels of justice turning, that's my one passion in life. Besides, if I left before 8, my pop would kill me.
What's this important business you're up to?
It's a legal matter. Very complicated, very abstruse. I need to obtain 5 sets of initials on every copy of this writ of indemnification before Pop... before Judge Brown can even think of granting a waiver to the party in the first part.
You have no idea what it's about, do you?
That's how important it is.
Sounds like you're a little scared of your father.
Scared of my father? Pop is the most learned, just, incorruptible judge that Hill Valley has ever seen. The only people scared of Judge Brown are people with a dark secret to hide. And I don't have a dark secret to hide.
Emmett, about
don't
your...
Don't say it! Your line operator. In that case, H to the A multiplied by the inverse of A minus. Now, if H stands for one dimensional harmonic oscillator, then naturally H to A multiplied by the inverse of A.
Will you just give me a chance?
Harassment's a federal crime, Mr. Crockett!
Emmett, about
don't
your.
Say it! Inverse.
Will you just give me a chance?
Harassment's a federal crime, Mr. Crockett!
See, I'm sort of in the science business myself. That's why I sought you out.
Not that I care in the least, because science is the furthest thing from my own area of interest, which is law, but I don't believe you.
It's true. I'm a scientist.
So tell me something, Mr. Scientist, from your vast storehouse of scientific knowledge.
The leg bone's connected to the thigh bone?
Amazing!
Emmett, about
don't
your...
say it!
I don't need to go in there anymore.
Now if H stands for one-dimensional harmonic oscillator, then naturally H2A multiplied by the inversion of H has to come out less than
expectation value of A right on a or do we take H to stand for the Hermitian line operator? Well, in that case, H to the A multiplied by the inverse of A might not be equal to A's expectation value.
Will you just give me a chance?
Harassment's a federal crime, Mr. Crockett!
Sounds like you're a little scared of your father.
Scared of my father? Pop is the most learned, just, incorruptible judge that Hill Valley has ever seen. The only people scared of Judge Brown are people with a dark secret to hide. And I don't have a dark secret to hide.
Damn it. About your...
Don't say it. Oh, let's start over. More secrets. Those mass times... Acceleration, of course. That's Newton. But how many Newtons are required to maintain...
Will you just give me a chance?
Harassment's a federal crime, Mr. Crockett!
Damn it. About your...
Don't say it.